लेंथी
A big good evening to all of you, and this is DC Celeb Talks on the special day, which is Valentine's Day. We are having a different type of a Valentine's Day celebration where we have parents coming in with queries regarding their parents and their children. Now, this sounds a little paradoxical or a little confusing. Let me introduce my three students to you who are now parents and who has spent their formative years with us at our tutorials. Now, as parents, what is their role? And as their children of their parents, what was their, the playful days that they had in their childhood? We're going to hear about all this. So it's going to be a fun talk, nothing serious, nothing to be taken to heart. A very simple request to all of you, because you may have to show these videos to your children. So please don't give sermons, because you never like to listen to sermons. And so your children do not obviously going to like it. Let me actually pass on the introduction mic to all of you. So one by one, you can introduce yourself. We'll start with Bhagyashree, ladies first. Bhagyashree, Abhishek and Surud have been my students, and they are here today with their respective spouses. We'll start with Bhagyashree. Yeah, can you introduce yourself?
Hello, I'm Vaidya Bhagyashree Patil, and I practice Ayurveda in Daisar, Matrewadi. I've been practicing for past 13 years. Overall, I'm a Nemlikarite, and I'm accompanied by my husband, Aditya.
Yeah, I'm Adit Shetty, and as Bhagyashree mentioned, I'm a husband, and I'm a software developer. I work for a company named Pearson, which is into education.
Yes, yeah. Abhishek.
Good evening, ma'am. So I'm from the 96 batch of Nemrikers, a proud student of Nemrikers, I would say.
Thank you.
And I work for Kodak. It's been almost 10 years. I've been working for Kodak. My overall experience in the industry has been close to 19 years now. And I'm here today with my wife, Janvi. And over to you, Janvi.
Hi all, this is Janvi here, I'm working as teacher, used to work in Rustamji, Cambridge only. And then we shifted to Thane, so now working with Shreema school as a second standard teacher.
Very good, very good. Surud, tell us something about yourself.
Yeah, hi, good evening, everyone. Hi to all the other participants. This is Surit Pawar here. I have also been with Abhishek. We've been with part of the Nemlikers family since 96. So that makes it almost 25 years that we have known each other. And it's been a great association with the family. I am from the advertising field. I work as an associate creative director with a healthcare advertising agency. And over to my wife, Shweta.
Hi, hi everyone. My name is Shweta, and I basically am working with Star Prabha. I take care of their consumer insights and programming strategy. And I have been associated with Nemlikers as a result of Surut for the past, I think, 10, 15 years now. Yeah, so.
Yeah, I would like to tell my Daisar Connect viewers a small, a secret that Shweta has a special link with me. The thing is, her father was my lecturer when I was in SIS college, and he was my lecturer for chemistry. And when I came to know that Surud is getting married to her, I said, chalo, it's a very good thing. Like, there's a link somewhere. So we have a special bond there also. I would like to now proceed with our, DC Celeb Talk. The first thing that comes to my mind is all of you have been at our classes. Now, let me tell the viewers something about myself, just a line about myself. I'm Professor Vijaya Nemlikar, and I had founded this tutorials, Nemlikar's tutorials, in the year 1996. And of course, before that, I was always into teaching since 1988. And 96 onwards, I founded this institute, and I have coached about 10,000 students and more till date, till the March 2019, when I said, a big goodbye to the tutorials, which had culminated into a private limited company also. But then I realized that I need some time for myself, for my own special spiritual reading. And that's why now I'm connecting with people. I'm trying to find out more with because when you stand on the other side of the fence, you're able to see better. Now coming to all of you, any one of you can start. I mean, we need not go by a gender-wise, preference. So if I can start with Abhishek, because alphabetically he comes first. Can you tell me some, I mean, all of you can tell me some things about memories about your childhood. Yes, Abhishek.
Ma'am, I think the best memory that I ever had for my childhood was the time that we had to go out and play cricket, after the school, and then after coming back home, spending a lot of time with friends in the evening. I think that was all about it, and that's a time that I'm really missing today. You know, when I look at even my kid today, I mean, that's not something that you know, she or he is going through. So that's something that I really miss about my childhood.
What about you, Chandni?
I should go with him only. The same thing. We used to go out the whole day. We used to play a lot. And there was no such thing that atami kai karu. The question comes nowadays, you know.
Exactly.
Yeah. They are having sympathies with them, but still, that time we had nothing to do, but nothing to play with. But we used to play a lot and we had a fun that time. That's
the best childhood memory. Correct, yeah. Childhood memories are like that. Yes, Bhagyashree, tell me something about your childhood.
My childhood memories, I always remember the May vacations most, because they were like without studies, fun all day, and then playing, having fun. Then I used to stay in Kandarpada from the starting. So we used to play on that Bhavdevi Mandirka, that hill,
yes,
right?
Yes.
We used to play on those rocks and all. So that was really a very nice thing and a very nice memory.
Very good. Adit, what about you?
Yeah, I mostly remember, you know, after school we used to have Bora and Bola and then 1 rupee Pepsi. That's something I still miss. Yeah, and the best thing was, you know, like we used to play most of the times. So, you know, I never thought about food then, unlike now.
What about Suru?
Well, so for me, childhood, like I would agree with Bhagyashree there, saying that May vacations, you know, if you ask any kid of our age, May vacations is something that will always come right on top. For me, that was, you know, the time I used to go to my native place with my grandparents, and I repeat the story, I've repeated about 50 times, or, you know, anyone I meet. School used to get over, I think the final exam used to get over at around 4th or the 5th of April. Mm-hmm. And I used to be in my native place in Ratnagiri the very next morning. I used to stay there for 2 months or whatever the time was. And June 13th, as you all remember, school used to start. I used to be back home on the 11th of June with just one day left buying uniforms and books and all that. So that is that forms a large chunk of my childhood. Bombay itself, by home, coming back home, I remember the time that my brother and I used to absolutely wreak havoc at home, because both my parents were working and we had the entire house to ourselves. So there was a lot of you know, pots banging around. We used to create our own music and just run around the house. Most important thing I remember is there was a great amount of freedom. And I concur with Abhishek saying that, you know, nowadays children find it very difficult. Abhi main kya karu? You know, what do I do now? What, back when we were kids, we never had that question. You know, we used to make do with whatever little we had. And there was always something new to explore, something new to, you know, discover. So that's something. Most of my childhood was spent outdoors, you know, on my cycle, scraping knees and breaking a few bones, some of my own, some of other people. So yeah, it was a great time, and we always look back fondly on those times.
Shweta, your memories?
Yeah. So my childhood memories, what I recollect the most is just fun. I think which is what I'm reading from everyone, right? Ki kitna maza karte the, how much we used to step out, how much we used to not stay at home. So we have, like, I have grown up in everyone else's house. I have grown up in a chawl setting where we were hardly ever at home. We have eaten in everyone's house. We have known everyone else's families much more than our own families at times. And so that is a sort of difference that I find now when I talk to children. And the dominant thing that they talk about is only studies. Correct. Versus the, in our time, I don't think we used to think about studies. As in, studies was like the last thing that we did. And not that we were bad students to begin with, but it was never the first thing. Our first thing was always like, when do we get home? When do we throw our backpacks away and just go and run and do something or the other and have fun? So that, well, I think as a, I do not know where the paradigm shift has happened, but I think that.
So what do you see as a difference between you as a child, maybe of, you know, the age of 3, 4 or 5 and your kids who are growing up now? What difference do you find?
One thing that I find is that I don't think my parents ever bothered so much. And I think I have become what the popular term is of a helicopter mom and a helicopter dad, right? Okay. Always there, kya kar rahe hain, kyun kar rahe hain, idhar kya ho raha, udhar kya ho raha, kya khaya, kyun nahi khaya. Versus, I don't think our parents even bothered. Like, they were like, jao, jo karna hai karo. You know, but now, like, I just keep trying to think, why has this happened? Now I'm trying to justify for my own self, thinking that, you know, the world has gone bad. Maybe everyone is not looking for the good for the children, which was a very different scene there, right? Right now, it's very difficult. As in, they are growing up in much more restricted spaces and much more just restricted lifestyle.
Their mindsets as well.
Yeah.
Earlier, our parents knew that there was someone or the other who would take care of our child. Even, you know, I distinctly remember there was one incident where my Masi had come over with her family, and my dad, Masi's husband and I, they took me along because I was just running around crying too much. So, mala pan ghunza. So my dad reluctantly took us out, and they were going out to get some chicken and some food or whatever. So along the way, I don't know what happened, heart chhoot gaya. Right? And I suddenly looked around, and my uncle is nowhere to be found, my dad is nowhere, and I'm right in the middle of the street. And obviously I started crying my eyes out, saying that mera baba, daddy mere ko chhod ke chala gaya karke. And luckily, Bhagyashree, you might remember Kirloskar Electricals, that store is there.
Yeah.
Uncle has been sort of, you know, the part of the entire Dicer West family for as long as I can remember. He saw me and he immediately recognized me, saying that, you know, so yaad hai rahega ke na, because he used to work, he has done a lot of work at our place as well.
Place, yeah.
So, being the gentle soul that he is, he picked me up, kept me on his, you know, storefront for 5 minutes. He shut down the entire store, put me on his bike,
and
dropped me home. And he dropped me home, saying, and in an admonishing tone, he said, "Kya tumche pura kute phirta hai, tumhala kai lakshat nahi hai." And then he went away. You know how he is, right? He's
correct,
very
yeah.
outspoken.
Yes,
but he
yes.
has a heart of gold. So all of that happened, that entire tamasha happened, and then my dad came home, and then he figured out that all of this has happened. So coming back to what I was saying, you know, our parents, they were always sure that someone is out there looking for our kids.
Correct, yeah.
And like Shweta mentioned, you know, we are growing up in more restricted spaces, more restricted mindsets. You know, we always hear people saying that amcha bazula kon rahta amala mahit nahi. And that is a sad state of affairs, because we have become so cloistered in our lives.
Correct. We have no space,
you know,
for others.
Like, go out for work, come back, have our dinner, and go out to sleep. And we don't have that space for others. It's like we're living in these, to use a marketing term, we are living in silos, and we think that anything outside of my protective bubble is going to harm myself or my kids.
Very
which,
nicely
which is a fact,
put, yeah.
But, you know, it has its own merits and demerits.
Correct.
So that is one thing that I find quite different in the way that we grew up and the way things are right now.
I would like to ask the two mothers who are here, Janvi as well as Bhagyashree, what is the difference you find, you know, being brought up as a girl and now the fact that you are bringing up your kids, one of them is a daughter. So what difference do you find? Are there restrictions in their behavior or in the societal behavior towards them?
I feel yes, restrictions are there, but it is there for a good purpose, definitely. And even I feel that whenever I'm telling my daughter that why I'm doing so, or, you know, convincing her that why I'm doing so, and she's very much convinced with that. So no issues with the upbringing part comes in when I'm telling her that these are the things which girls are facing.
Correct.
Nowadays.
Correct.
Okay. And the difference which I see is when I got, to be very frank, when I got my first periods, okay, I was very much, you know, frightened, and I was very much confused. Correct. Though some part of knowledge was there, but still I was a little bit confused. But when Correct. My daughter went, and she was very much happy with it. She knew what it is.
Correct.
It is not just because that I told her anything about it. Hmm. It is because the available source which are available for them nowadays. Hmm. So that is the difference which I see.
Achha.
I think, ma'am, I'll just add something over here. Today, when we are in the world of internet and everybody is connecting with everyone, as Surut rightly suggested, he showed one flip side of it that people are not connecting, you know. So we don't talk to each other much. I don't recollect talking to Surut for a very long time now, though we would have chatted sometime or we would have sent a message, hi, hello and something. But we don't connect the way we used to connect earlier. Yes. And I think that's the major difference. Today, the information is available. It is there at our fingertips. How we use it or, you know, to what extent we use it, I think is more important.
Good.
I think going out, meeting people, having no restrictions, meeting your neighbors, going down and playing with your friends, trying to have some, you know, kids kitty party or maybe, you know, going out for a small picnic here and there, bringing something, you know, some cooked food from your home, doing something, but getting along together, sharing, caring. I think those are the things which, we really miss today. I think when I look at my kids, I definitely see that, you know, they are missing all this.
Correct. As what Janvi also said, a very important point that, you know, and we can fuse it with your point also, Abhishek, that children nowadays are more accessible to information. The only thing, as what Janvi said, is they get it from the right source, then they are happy about the changes which are taking place in them. That's a very good point. Bhagyashree, what about you? Because I think your daughter is now, in a few years, she'll be in the early teens. So how are you going to tackle her issues, like, you know, as a teenager?
Basically, during my time, my mom used to be slightly on a strict side. And my dad was very lenient with me. I'm an only child, so they used to balance it out very well. I think here again, we are balancing it out very well. In my case and in Adit's case. The thing is, that time, parents were not so much vocal about things. Whereas from now itself, we are trying in some or the other way to give some kind of hint to Kanika that in future, like what Janvi said, that getting periods and all that when it starts and everything. So in slightest manner, we are trying to give her hints that there are some things that in the future which we need to tell you about, and in a different way, like.
Correct.
Okay. So I think in a way we have already started preparing her, though she's just 8 years now, but still we want her to know every aspect of it.
Correct.
So that when she comes to that point, it shouldn't be something very different that is going to happen. Unlike what happened with us, like me, Janvi, exactly. Or anyone of that age group.
Yeah. Now, you're taking the same thing further. I would like to ask you, like, you know, there are certain incidents which have happened in each one of us, you know, in our childhood with each one of us. And those incidents at that moment, we were quite upset with our parents for having, you know, putting a certain restriction on us. But now when we ask or when we find that our kids are doing the same thing, do you think as a parent, you are putting a restriction? So were your parents correct in their role? Are you correct in your role? Or are the kids correct in their role? I mean, what is your take on this? Yeah, Adit can also.
I'm glad you asked.
Yeah, because.
I'm glad you asked this because I always used to feel that mummy uggats kai sangte, hey restriction, they restriction, asano ko karu, tasano ko karu. She always had something. And I always used to feel that it's too much of restriction. Like, but when it comes to Kanika and this point of time, when I see ki all those things, whatever she said, I find myself saying the same thing to Kanika. So at that point of time, now I understand that what my mother used to say is 100% right. Like,
so it's like karma pays back, no? Yes, Adit, as a father, how are you? Like, are you a very strict father or are you quite lenient? Is your daughter very close to you or to Bhagyashree? Like, you know, I would like to...
She is more close to Bhagyashree, but it depends on the time. Sometimes I'm strict, sometimes I'm, you know, more lenient. Like my father.
And on a lighter note, I think it also depends on the demand she has. If she has a demand which she knows is going to be fulfilled by the mother, she'll be closer to her at that moment.
But making her understand things, actually. I mean, whatever query she has or even about life, whatever explanations she wants, I think Adit does it very well. I'm not very good at explaining things, but Adit does it very well. Like anything, if something is wrong, he has to direct her towards something, being being a good individual, inculcating good values. Adit is very good at it. I mean, telling her why it is so important.
Now, coming to Surud, I would like to ask you, because I have known you since you were in the 9th. I think we've lost connection with Surud. Can you hear me, Surud?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Just trying to switch networks because
Okay. The question that I had for you was, I have been, I know you since you were in your 13, 14, jo teenage ka group tha, tabhi se maine tumko dekha hai. And you are a little, I always used to feel you're a genius kind of a person. So do you see your, your quality in any of your kids? And when you see that, do you feel that you were restricted? You were restricted as a, child from doing that, but you can't do the same thing to your child now.
Yeah, that's the. See, just to start off with, we've got twins, one boy and one girl, and they have equal qualities of our positive and negative qualities in each of them. So. The boy, I think, is a little more skewed towards my side because he is a little more self-sufficient. He doesn't need attention all the time. He will keep playing with one thing and, it's easy to keep him occupied. The girl on the other side, she needs attention. She needs stimulation all the time. And she's like Shweta. So,
these are like cheap shots on Valentine's.
No, Surud has got back even on you, Shweta, because he laughed at him loudly when he was called a genius.
No, because I knew what was coming.
So, now they had their second birthday a couple of weeks back. So it's too early to predict what they will turn into. But right from the start, going back to the question, about girls for that matter, are they, how do we treat them? How, what is the kind of difference that we see? So right from going back to when I was in 8th, 9th standard, when I joined Nimlayers, that distance or the difference in treatment was always apparent. Girls are always expected to be home at a certain time. Saat Char Gharat was a super date. And for obvious reasons, that was the deadline that girls had. And boys were like, kabhi bhi aajao ghar pe, as long as you come in one piece, it's fine. and I remember one picnic that we had gone out, I think Alibag or somewhere, where we had got stuck in traffic. And I think we got delayed by some three or four hours. And the dropping off point was Vithal Mandir. And I distinctly remember all of us getting down and all the girls' parents were livid. Absolutely. You could see that anger in their faces. They grabbed the girls by the arms and just like dumped them into the rickshaw and took them home. Then later during the week, we had our conversations and all that on our way back. Mereko bahut gaali mila. Ye kya time hai kya wapas aane ka? Tum log ka teacher ko samajhta nahi hai kya? Ladka ladki log ko kidhar bhi leke jaate. And all of those, society, so to speak, at that time. But now, if you look at the way girls and boys are being raised, everything is equal. Even for our girl also, we consciously we make that effort because we've got nannies at home who are from a different system.
Correct,
so when they ask Vibhor, my son, our son rather, Vibhor kai chalavnar, to Vibhor bike chalavnar. Ani Gatha kai chalavnar, Gatha scooty chalavnar. So they got a kitchen set for her, they got a jeep for the boy. So these are conditioned responses that exist beyond our sphere, which we can't do much about. But then,
we try
to switch between the jeeps and the kitchen sets whenever we can.
Correct.
And to be frank, my boy likes the kitchen more.
He likes
dresses more.
So there are times that he has gone out of the house wearing dress, and we have trained the nannies to not tell him anything. And now they have started training the entire building to not tell him anything.
Oh, very good.
So that's how those little changes happen. Otherwise, I think.
Otherwise, we would be stuck in the same circle, right? Ladki log ko ye nahi karna hai, ladko ko ye karna hai, and all
that. So those restrictions are sort of, I think, we are trying to deal with the gender divide. But I think as as parents, as children, I think the restrictions are the same. Like, you know, disciplining, respect, being kind. I think those are things that even our parents taught us. Those are things that we will also try and teach our children. I think what is really different is that when we used to do anything that went against them, we were like beaten up. And we were told you are not supposed to do it because there is no two ways about it. Whereas I think now as a parent, I at least consciously try and explain it to my child, no matter if they're just 2 years old, and try and explain to them why. Because I think that's what I missed out on growing up. Because I wasn't told why I have to like pair chore of some elder, or why I have to like not call someone by name. So those things I try to answer for the kids, even though I think that some of it they understand, some of the kids they don't. But at least I try to.
Correct.
So that is one thing that I have consciously started doing as a restriction, as a change in the sort of the way we deal with the restriction. So that is one thing.
Yeah.
Okay, Abhishek, you also have two kids, a girl and a boy. How are you finding the difference bringing them up? Like, you know, as what Surud said, like, you know, if in Surud's case, if his children go for a camp, like how we had gone, and if the bus is delayed at the traffic or something, then he's going to grab his daughter by the arm and possibly leave the son. But what about you? Are you going to do some similar action, or you're going to have a different way of, you know, treating the situation?
I think, ma'am, we all are selling the same boat. So when it comes to Neeti, I'm stunningly protective. So it's pretty obvious, but yeah. I give her that liberty. So she has, I mean, she can go out to play for a long time. The only thing is she has to keep us informed. And we do try and explain the rationale behind it, why exactly we are trying to say so, we make her understand. And once we do that, I think the kids today are matured enough that they understand what their parents are trying to tell them. And as per that, you know, she responds, and she responds very affirmatively. Positively, she responds on that. So that's a good part. As far as my son is concerned, he is just 1 year old as of now. So, I mean, the entire world is open for him. So there is no binding, there is no restriction. Whatever he does he is on his own. He's on autopilot at one point of time. So,
yeah.
I mean, there are two pilots who stay behind him, and his flight is always in the takeoff mode. So somebody is there. Whether he falls, whether he, you know, he will pull something out. So he makes sure that even if we don't go out for a walk, you know, that's fine. You know, we still go around him in the house. I think that's good of an exercise for all of us.
Yeah, that's what Abhishek was telling me the other day. I would like to share it with the others. He said that his child was born during the lockdown period. I think sometime in March, if I'm not wrong. And
November 5th. He was born, and then after March 2020, we had this
lockdown. So he had something very nice to say, that his child has not seen human beings on the road at all. So this is something which is a very different situation. And I'm sure the child is going to be, as what you said, he's going to be a self-learner. So he's going to understand that these are creatures who look like us and who behave differently in different situations. So anyway, that's a good thing. I'm really happy that, you know, there are such innovations also happening in this present situation. During this lockdown period, like, you know, your children were connected to online coaching, either for their school or for their coaching classes. So how did you cope up with that? How did you manage that? Bhagyashree and Adit, both of you can take turns to answer,
Yeah. About the studies, I think Adit would tell you better, because for this year, the studies is completely interesting to
me. Yeah, that is the reason I included him in this, yes.
coping up in the sense, you know, like, there's nothing much to do, you know, once you just let them up with the laptop, then they're on their own. But I could see, you know, like for a few days, it was all exciting. But after that, you know, like, for the kids, at least, it was very boring. At least my daughter keeps saying that she's waiting for the school to open.
Uh-huh.
She gets really bored, you know, because it's like a virtual world.
Uh-huh.
You don't meet anyone. Her life has become exactly like mine now, because I work from home most of the time. So I'm always in a virtual world now. So her life is also become virtual.
And okay. I would like to tell you one thing. Before lockdown, normally she is someone who would not like to go out of the house. She would always like to stay in the house, play in the house, everything in the house.